student. I mean, all of this has been sealed shut, and I just believe that the hidden things will come to light. That when there is such a cloud of secrecy, when anyone who dares suggest that we ought to make sure the Constitution's bare minimal qualifications are followed, that you're told that you need to take the Reynolds wrap off your head, that you get called every name in the book, there's something to this.
Something about the circumstances of his birth. He wants hidden. Now, what is that? It might have a bearing on the eligibility question, or it might not. But when I sit and try to think about what could possibly be in a birth certificate that would bother anybody, right? Nobody I know of holds a newborn infant responsible for the things his parents might be or do. So the only other reason than the eligibility question would be that he, Barack Obama, has been telling lies about who he is and about his real background. Has built up a persona for himself based upon those lies and fabrications, and this would all be shown. If somebody actually saw the birth certificate, they'd start to unravel it. Those are two possibilities.
We're also in a stage, though, where some people don't want us to see what's going on. They want us to close our eyes to it or be ignorant of it. That Obama represents the imposition of a communist-style government on the United States. And that we ought to call things by their right name. He's somebody who came along with a commitment to Marxist-Leninist-type socialism. And what I mean when I say that is clear. It's even in U.S. law, by the way, the definition of what communism is about. It has a economic dimension, which is socialist. You take over the private sector. Now, people tell me that it doesn't matter because people don't care anymore about communism. And I think to myself, no, people wouldn't have, they reacted like scalded cats, the usual propagandists of the left and others, and tried to portray me as some kind of fringe kook and all this because I call them anti-communists. They reacted this way because they know good and well that many, many, many of the people, even amongst those who went to the polls and voted for this guy, they didn't vote for communism. If he had gotten up at the Democrat National Convention and given a speech in which he advocated the establishment of an American KGB, that is, a domestic security force as large and well-funded as the military.
We cannot continue to rely only on our military in order to achieve the national security objectives that we've set. We've got to have a civilian national security force that's just as powerful, just as strong, just as well-funded.
If he had gotten up and advocated government control of every aspect of our economic life so that the politicians will hire and fire.
A stunner from Detroit. General Motors boss Rick Wagner is quitting at White House request.
This is not meant as a condemnation of Mr. Wagner, who's devoted his life to this company and has had a distinguished career.
Senator Robert Byrd, is a Democratic U.S. senator, he wrote on February 23rd a letter to the president complaining essentially of a power grab. He's complaining that by naming health czars or urban affairs policy experts or energy experts at the White House, that what he was trying to do is grab power from the U.S. Senate.
Will control salaries, will dictate the terms of labor and the products. If he had advocated this.
That if tax dollars are being put on the line, they are being invested in a real fix that will make Chrysler more competitive. And that is why, as part of this agreement, we will be providing additional capital to GMAC to help unlock our frozen credit markets. And tomorrow, the Small Business Administration will be announcing it is expanding eligibility for some loans to include more suppliers and dealers, including RV dealers.
If he had advocated policies that represented the total surrender of our national security, an appeasement of the terrorists in the world, where we declare the war against terror to be over.
My administration is now committed to diplomacy that addresses the full range of issues before us and to pursuing constructive ties among the United States, Iran, and the international community.
While they continue to make war against us in Iran and Al-Qaeda and Hezbollah and all of these places.
دشمنی شما با ملت ایران تغییر کرده کو علامتش دارایی های ملت ایران را آزاد کردید تحریم های ظالمانه را برداشتید از لجن پراکنی و اتهام زنی و تبلیغات سو علیه این ملت بزرگ و مسئولین مردمی اون دست برداشتید.
The other aspect is that you blur the distinction between the party and the government. So that essentially the key decisions about the direction of the country are being made by a party elite.
Kyle, when the House last week passed a bill that said they could go back and take 90% of the money from the people at AIG, everybody was happy with that for a second, but wait a second. What if in fact then that means Congress can take 90% of your money? And if they can take one group's money, they can take another group's money, and they can do it after the fact. And by the way, those bonuses had been approved by Congress in the stimulus package they voted for. So the hypocrisy and the, I think, danger is very real. And then look at what they're trying to do on the budget, where they're trying to ram through a resolution to break the rules of the Senate to be able to get through both an energy tax increase and a massive change in our health system on 51 votes, which is clearly a power grab of unprecedented proportions. I think dictatorial is a strong word, but it may frighteningly be the right word.
All of those elements are taking place in America. The Porculus bill was essentially about using public funds with the money flowing to the political cadre like Acorn that are being used to implement a political agenda by the present occupant of the White House.
To stay in a house which you can't afford and you cannot pay the bills, and what right do you have to get my money to pay for you? Well, was this right? I've read the Constitution. I don't see that right.
Well, actually, I don't see the right that banks have to get $700 billion to be bailed out when they haven't done.
That's a different thing.
It's all part of the same thing.
No, it's not. It's not.
Every 13 seconds,
are you quoting? What? I don't care.
People are foreclosed on. They have the right to protect their homes and to protect their community.
Let's back up a second. Let's back up a second.
It's the most American thing you can do.
Really?
Is to protect your home and protect your community.
The community group Acorn calls Donna a victim of predatory lending.
This is our house now.
And this afternoon, they literally broke the padlock right off the front door and then broke into the house, letting Donna back in for the first time in months.
We're actually trespassing. And so this is a way of civil disobedience to try to stay into our house. Legally, it's wrong. But homesteading is the only means that she has left to stay into her house, and we feel as though that this is the right thing to do at this particular time to save this family.
But you then take advantage of the fact that that credit access is going on to impose a dictatorship upon every aspect of business. And this was illustrated in this episode and is now being, as you know, put into law and will affect everything. Personnel decisions, salary decisions of everybody in a company that gets any money directly from the government.
I can tell you for sure that I represent one less investor today than I represented yesterday. One of my clients was directly threatened by the White House and in essence compelled to withdraw its opposition to the deal under threat that the full force of the White House press corps would destroy its reputation if it continued to fight.
Do you think that after he gave that speech at the Democrat National Convention, they would have said, what a moderate guy he is?
No, I
wouldn't. Do you think that Americans would have stood up and said, well, he talks so well and so forth? I think they would have said, this guy's a flaming red. He's a commie. He represents everything we fought against for decades. Our people died. Our treasure was expended to stop this form of government from taking over in other countries, and we're going to surrender to it here? No, wouldn't have happened.
U.S. Rep. Bill Posey of Florida proposed a bill, H.R. 1503, requiring future presidential candidates to produce a birth certificate, together with other documentation establishing their qualification for eligibility to the office of president under the Constitution. This bill has also been co-signed by four other congressmen, Representatives Bob Goodlatte, John R. Carter, John Culberson, Randy Neugebauer.
Thank you.
decided to distribute it to a conference on January 23rd.